Now let us talk about the next important data structure, which is nothing but tuple. Okay, so now let us understand the definition characteristics of a tuple. Tuple is like object with unnamed attributes. So typically, if you are familiar with object oriented concepts, okay, so what you'll be doing, you will be creating class and then the class name, let's say order, and then you will be defining the all the attributes with respect to that class. So I'm using the Java syntax here because I'm not very comfortable with Python object oriented concepts, but this is how you actually define a class in Java. Okay, then you will be defining the data type of each of the elements, right? So, and then you will be having order status also. Like this, you will have multiple attributes of within a given class, right? And then if you want to create an object of it, you will be saying order equal to new order, and you will be passing values to it. You need to have constructor and all those things, and then the object will be created. But we need to have the structure for our objects. If you don't need to, the answer is tuple. So tuple is nothing but object with attributes, but no names to those attributes. What is the impact of that? As there are no names to the attribute, with respect to Java object, if you create the Java object like this, after creating the object, you can actually say order.orderID, and you should be able to read the elements by using these names of the attributes. As we don't have names to our attributes, if I just want to create an object without attributes, I just have to invoke a constructor like this. 1 and then 2013 07 25, and then 11,599, and then closed. Okay, so if we put in circular brackets and if I assign it to a variable or t, it is termed as tuple, which is very, very generic term. And you have an object, the object name is t, but this object doesn't have attributes associated with it, means names for these attributes associated with them. As there are no names for these attributes, the only way you can access these attributes of this object is by using the positional notation. Means I can index by using position, and I should be able to read the data. So if I have to read first element from this tuple, I can say t of 0. The syntax is very similar to list, but fundamentally they are different. Okay, in list the elements are supposed to be homogeneous, whereas in tuple the elements are typically heterogeneous. The reason is, if you think about an object, each attribute in an object is of different type, can be of different type, and a tuple is representing an object with attributes but no names to those attributes. Okay, so in one line, if I have to define tuple, it is an object with attributes but no names to them, or an object with unnamed attributes. Hence, we can only access the elements using positional notation like this, like t of 0 to give first element, or t of 3 to give the fourth element, etc. You can see here, when I say t of 3, give the fourth element. You can see a type on tuple. You can see it is of type tuple, and you can get help on it, and you can see the APS. Okay, it has contains to check if the element is part of the tuple or not. It's almost same as list. But there are only two APIs with respect to tuple. One is count and second one is index. Index is, it will tell where the element is in the tuple. Count is how many times a particular element is repeated in the tuple. Apart from this APIs, you don't have anything at all. Now comes the relationship between collection and tuple. So as I have mentioned to you earlier, collection, if you want to compare collection with RDBMS terms, collection is similar to table, where table have group of rows, collection have group of elements, and each element or each row is of type same, is homogeneous type. Okay, which means all the elements in a collection or all the rows in a table are homogeneous. Tuple is like a individual record where you have multiple values of different types with different attribute names. That's what, right? If you take one row in a table and you will be finding multiple columns such as order ID, order date, order customer ID, and order status, and each of these type, each of these attribute type can be different. Okay, so if you want to compare the tuple with a RDBMS term, it is similar to a individual record within the table. Okay, and also tuple is nothing but object with attributes but no names associated with them. As there are no names, we can only access using positional notation. Because tuple is like a row in a table, we typically create collection of tuples. So if I have to create a collection of objects, and if I don't want to give names to those objects, then I will be using tuple as nested structure within the collection. Now, if you go back to the dict, okay, and you see here, we created key value pairs such as one hello, two world, and then one how are you, three world, and we have updated them. And there were three elements in D1 after updating with D2, right? You have one how are you, two world, and three world, okay? And if I say D1 dot values, or not values, items, keys will give only keys, values will give only values, and items returns all the elements in this dict in the form of a list, and each element is a tuple, okay? So So you can actually say type of d1.items, which is nothing but a list, and then take the first element of it and take the type of it. And you can see I have to pass this dict items into a list before I use subscript here, okay? And you can see it is of type tuple, okay? So we'll be using tuples quite a bit in conjunction with the collections, that you will understand with the programs which will be developing using different approaches to manipulate these collections.